didn't ken any better. I'd say we were being haunted
by a very hungry ghost.
Hmm? That is not where I left it.
Or where I put it.
Freezer!
Good day to you, gentlemen.
It will be, when you've paid the rent you owe. All alone here, are we?
Well, my bairn's in his cradle, and Fergus will be home before long.
If he won't be long, that's my brother and I'll wait. Don't mind, do you?
There's no need to wait. I'll gladly pay you what you're owed.
If only that was the sole cause for my complaint.
Then again, what you speak of?
I'll not stand for tenants behaving this way, raising their hands against my brother. Give us double, or you'll be out in the street.
You should be ashamed of yourselves.
Aye. You should be. In more ways than one.
And who in God's name are you?
Told you she was a woman of wanton morals. Now she's entertaining men here while her husband's out.
I'll not see a property of mine become a house of ill repute.
What did you say? The only persons of ill repute will be you and your cowardly brother when the good people of Wilmington find out you're threatening a woman in our home.
Have I seen your face before?
This is my grandsire. He's come quite some way to see the bairn.
It's a face you won't long forget once I knock some sense into you. So, you're claiming the lass here hit you?
No, it was her husband.
Oh. Oh, I see. Must have hit you hard.
As if a mere woman could do such a thing.
It's ridiculous.
Mm. Glad we're in agreement and we've established that the lass has done no wrong. Mm. That's a nasty bruise. I'm wondering, are you sure it was the Frenchman who hit you?
I'd swear to it.
You ken that your tenant wears a wooden hat. So, you have a bruise on your right cheek made by the left fist of a man who does not have one.
The lass did hit you then?
Surely no ill feelings now I've paid what we owe. I'll put these two hands to good use. Preparing supper then.
We are in agreement. You've been paid what you're due.
Settled. In full. You'll pay for this, you lying little
shit. Good day to you, gentlemen. I must admit, there have been times where I've wished you weren't here. Crowded as we are. But other times, I've wished you truly were my grandsire, as you've been to Fergus.
I only wish I could help you and Fergus out more with the rent. The only silver I have is in my hair.
Well, you've a heart of gold.
That's another thing we're gonna have to keep quiet about.